The Emmy award-winning series, Eyewitness Los Angeles. Tonight, these stories, lowriders and big bikers peel down the pavement when we do the drags with street racers trying to get off the road. It's a scene firmly founded in the 50s. An empty parking lot on a dark Angel Town night. Then suddenly, called together through an organized underground grapevine mob Bellwood envy, hot rodders, lowriders, and big bikers step from the shadows and into the streetlights. And to the tune of tearing tires, the streets of Smogville become a racetrack, where supercharged dragsters challenge the police for after-dark dominance of the pavement.
Now, street racers underground is unorganized. Normally what they do, they meet at a shopping center, or a parking lot, or a hamburger stand, whatever. They meet at this hamburger stand, they get together, they look at their cars, they talk, they look at the bikes, the lowriders be dancing, and you know, and everybody be checking out their machines. But then there's the excitement, competition. My car or my motorcycle is better than your car. You know, my bike is quicker than your bike. And then next thing you know, there's a little gambling. Sometimes it's just for the prestige of it. And they pick a street at random, a good long street, and they go out and they get it on.
These fast-paced, late-night gear grinders have generated more than just residue rubber. Soon after the Watts riots, the drivers of the dark drags gathered in the daylight to green flag the above-ground International Brotherhood of Street Racers. Segwaying into the 70s and surfacing definitely legit, the Brotherhood is racing for a precious prize.
I got to make this clear. Our main goal at that racetrack, our main product that we want to produce is Brotherhood. Everybody understand that? Let me hear. Now, what we are trying to produce?
Brotherhood!
All right.
I know for a fact that there are attorneys involved. There are some law enforcement officers involved. Now, I'm talking about in the organization, not in actively involved in street racing per se. I think the foundation and the concept of his organization is solid.
I think it's a great idea. It provides not only an opportunity to give these youngsters an outlet, but it helps build brotherhood. They are built upon the theme of brotherhood through street racing.
Driving hard to discourage draggers from doing it in the street, the Brotherhood and their main man and founder, Big Willie Robinson III, have a dream. A permanent off-street racetrack that will be open to all. And they've staked out what they feel is prime turf for their Brotherhood Raceway Park, an abandoned Navy airstrip on Terminal Island, now being used as a driver training track for LA cops.
Officially, we do not sanction the streets anymore because, you know, this is our major project now. We feel that this place here, we can run every weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. It's an M3 zone. We can run around the clock. That way the kids don't have any reason to be on the public streets. So what we've done, we'll transfer it from the public streets to a private street. This is our private street out here.
Pounding pavement, pushing their project, the Brotherhood has gotten the green light from the police department, the city council, and Mayor Bradley. They've even held several full-scale all-day drags at the potential park. However, their dream has run right into some rough road.
Our main objective out here is to bring the kids out here, keep them out here on the weekends. But it seems as though the general manager of the Harbor don't quite go along with that program. He tells me that he's for the program, he's a racer himself, but yet and all, red tape, red tape, red tape.
The concept of brotherhood and street racing is one thing that we can certainly sympathize with and share with and agree with. But when it converts to a business, in effect, of establishing a permanent raceway park, then that has to be considered in the context of the purpose of the state tidelands that we administer. As far as we are concerned, Big Willie's application for the use of Reeves Field has been denied, and there is currently no application pending and currently no action being done.
In a recent move, the Harbor Department relented, granting the Brotherhood rights to run 8 races to raise bucks to rebuild the old Lions drag strip. But this at first seemingly sensible solution blows its engine when faced with the fact that Lions was originally shut down because its noise annoyed residential neighbors. The Brotherhood has run a clean race and proven their potential. It now remains with the Harbor Department to checker flag the Brotherhood Raceway Park or drive down their dream and run them right back onto the streets.
That we as local law enforcement can really handle the street racing problem. We get it piecemeal, but in total, there's just no way. There's too many of them, too many different places. It's too well organized. And I just can't help but believe that if these fellows had a place to go race, which is what they've been advocating since day one, when they wanted to race, the street racing in Los Angeles would drop to practically nothing.
Motor cool down, heat went down, that's what I heard, that highway sound. Cadillac thin like a ton of lead, 110, half a mile ahead. Cadillac looking like thin steel, and I caught Maybelline at the top of the hill. Maybelline!